Mel from AdventuresWithMel.com, where I share all sorts of recipes, including healthy dinner ideas and desserts. And I also share travel adventures and outdoor adventures that my family and I enjoy together. So today, I'm going to be showing you how to make a shortcut pie pastry or pie crust. It's one of my grandma's recipes, so I actually have her recipe card here. But it's a really easy pie crust that you don't have to roll out, and you actually press it into your pan, and it's a no-fail recipe. You can't fail at it. It's so easy. And there's no fluting required either, so no decorative edges to worry about. You just make it, press it in, put your filling in, and go. It's perfect for fruit pies, and I also like using it for custard pie. I'm trying to think of some other pies I've made with it. I think it would probably be really good with pumpkin pie. Any type of cobbler, fruit cobbler, blackberry, even blueberry or peach cobbler. It's a really good crust with peach cobbler. So we're gonna go ahead and get started. And I'm gonna go over the ingredients with you really quick. And I've got some other things because I'm gonna be creating another recipe here in just a little bit. But we're gonna use flour, sugar, salt, oil, this is an oil-based crust, and milk. So I'm gonna go ahead and get out my 2 cups of flour, and I actually need to grab a measuring cup really quick. Cooking, so I'm going to add 2 cups of flour to the bowl. So right one. And I usually use a knife to level it off, but I don't happen to have one on me, so I'm just going to use my finger. We've got 2 cups of flour, and now we're going to put in 2 teaspoons of sugar. So I'm going to grab my teaspoon. I love a mixing bowl with a handle. One of my favorite. I use this thing all the time to mix up different batters and crusts and things. So we're going to mix that up, and then we're going to add in 1 1/4 teaspoon of salt. So we got one, and I'm just going to guess on the quarter. Probably good. All right, so mix all these dry ingredients up together. Now I'm going to set it to the side, and I'm going to bring out my measuring cup because we are going to mix together 2/3 of a cup of oil and 3 tablespoons of milk. Now I'm using canola oil because I feel like, well, that's just personal preference. I'm using canola oil. You can use vegetable oil. I don't know about olive oil for this particular recipe. You could probably use coconut oil. That would probably give it a really cool flavor too. I'm gonna grab the milk real quick. We're gonna do 3 tablespoons of milk. Now, I remember my mom using a crust like this when I was growing up with all of her cobblers. It was similar to this. It wasn't exactly like this, but it was an oil-based crust, and it was really delicious with peach cobbler. And it's actually really flaky. It's surprisingly flaky. I guess it's the oily texture. I'm going to set that back there because we're going to be using that again in a minute. But you're just going to whip this up good Now, Grandma's recipe also says to sift the flour, but I don't do that, not on this recipe. I would if it were a cake or cookies, but since it's just a pie crust, I'm not really that worried about it. So then you're just going to mix it up with your fork. And a fork works the best. It doesn't clump all over it. It's easy to get in there and really stir it. Makes it good. And it's going to be quite crumbly. That's how you want it to be. You just want to make sure that all of the flour, all of the dry ingredients are moistened well. And then it's ready to press into your pan. This is a super quick and easy pie crust you can make on the fly if you're not wanting to go to all the work of rolling one out. It's really nice in that way. I could see using this crust for a pecan pie too. That would probably be really good. Alright, so now if you're making a fruit pie, let me look at my recipe again. I have to look at it to make sure I'm telling you right. Yeah, if you're making a fruit cobbler or a pie, you want to save about a third of this or a quarter of it for the top crumbling, because you'll crumble it on top of your filling. But, and I'm not going to use all of it, but I'm not making a fruit pie with this. I'm going to be making a custard pie. So, I'm going to put in what I think I'm going to need to cover this pan. And if you notice, I'm using a pan, which it really doesn't matter what kind you use, but I'm using one that doesn't have the decorative edge, so I don't have to contend with that. But if you want a little bit of a decorative edge, then you can press it in and get that. But really, I just want to press it up around on the bottom and up on the sides. You don't want it to be too thick so that it cooks through when you cook your cobbler, because you're going to be adding your filling to it without cooking it. At least for a fruit pie, you would do that. And I do that for the custard pie as well. Use your knuckles and just kind of get in there and press it in. You can even use your fingertips. Doesn't matter. Whatever works for you. And perfection goes out the window with this pie crust. It does not have to be perfect. It's about making a dessert that everyone will love and enjoy together. Perfect for the holiday season. That's kind of how I like to look at my recipes. I mean, sometimes I get into the whole, you know, has to be perfect mode when I'm trying to take pictures, but when I'm creating it for family to enjoy, that's what it's all about. It's not about perfection. It's about making it so that everyone can just enjoy a really delicious dessert together and chat and talk, share stories, and maybe the taste of it brings back memories and you guys reminisce or, you know, talk about old times. That's what I love about baking and sharing the things that you make with other people. So I kind of go around the edge and just kind of get in here up against the edge and just kind of even it all out. Now this pie crust, you could chill it if you wanted to. Like if you were saving it for the next day to make a pie, it's not going to hurt anything. But I haven't found a need to chill it to keep it from shrinking. It does not seem to shrink at all. So it stays and keeps its shape, keeps its form really well. All right. So we've got our pie crust. And now we're ready to make something to fill it up and make a pie. To bake this pie crust, you'll just follow the directions for whatever pie recipe you happen to be making. It's usually used with filling that you're going to put in on the uncooked crust. So if you guys have any questions, be sure and leave me a comment. I'll check and I'll answer. Every so often I'll check and then I'll answer you back. If there's something you're wondering about or have a question about the technique or even the ingredients, anything, just leave a comment. I'm happy to chat and answer any questions that you might have. But I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like my recipes, be sure and share them out with your friends. And I will see you next time.